In the 172nd verse of Vivekachudamani, Shankaracharya continues the point that everything is because of the mind. He says, Vayuna aniyate megaha, punastenaiva niyate, manasa kalpyate bandaha, mokshastenaiva kalpyate. There is an Upanishad called the Amrita Bindu Upanishad. In that, there is a mantra, Mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha muktahe. That mind alone is the reason for bondage and liberation of people. Here too, Shankaracharya says, Vayuna aniyate megaha. Just like megaha, clouds are brought by vayu, winds. If you see, the clouds are moved from one place to another by winds. And again, punaha tenaiva niyate. And also it is the cloud, it is the wind which removes the clouds from one place. So it brings clouds from some other place and again moves them away from one place to another place. Similarly, bandaha manasa kalpyate. Bondage is thought of or conceived by the mind. Similarly, tenaiva mokshaha kalpyate. The very same mind thinks of liberation. The same mind can bring about liberation. In the Yoga Sutras, there is a concept of pratipaksha bhavana or opposite mood or opposite thinking. What is the pratipaksha bhavana? Suppose you see evil all around you. What should we do as a spiritual practice? We try to see good instead. Instead of harping about evil, instead of constantly thinking about evil, you try to think about the good which is there around you. Similarly, if you have some problems, if you have some bad tendencies of the mind, if you have some bad habits in the mind, what is the best method to get rid of that habit? Not by brooding over that habit, but instead cultivating good habits and cultivating good tendencies in your mind. If you do this again and again, and if you do them in a sustained manner over a longer period of time, and if you have more and more of good tendencies or good habits, then you will say that automatically the bad habits lose their hold over you. Sri Ramakrishna put it very nicely that if you want to go away from the south direction, start going moving towards the north. Don't think about south that, oh, I have to go away from south. Instead, you start moving towards the north and south will automatically be put away. So the same mind which creates problems, the same mind which creates attachment and then aversion, and also because of attachment and aversion, so much of suffering. So you are attached to some people, some things, some events in your life, and or you are averse to certain people, certain things or certain kinds of events which happened in your life, and that creates so much suffering, mental suffering, physical suffering, etc. That is the whole problem of our existence. But mind, it is the same mind which tries to concentrate on the ultimate reality of your personality, Atman, or it tries to concentrate on your chosen deity. It could be Rama, it could be Krishna, it could be anyone. The same mind tries to concentrate on that, and the same mind tries to repeat the mantra, and same mind tries to meditate. And it is through this very mind that you can attain your highest reality. You can also realize God. So it is up to us how we use this mind. Just like technology, we have got technology, and it is very common for people to say that because of technology, my peace of mind has gone. I have lost my peace of mind. But technology can be used to get your peace of mind, because you don't need to, like in the past, depend on so many things. You can be wherever you want. You can be on your vacation. You can do whatever you want. And with your smartphone, you can manage pretty much everything of your office work or other work. So that gives you a lot of freedom to do whatever you want. But people don't look at it that way, because we get used up by the technology. We get used by social networking websites. We get used by apps like WhatsApp, etc. And then we think that it is the social networking website or these apps or internet or technology in general that is creating problem. But they are not creating problem. To use a very old example, they say that using the light of a lamp, you can write great poems, you can write great novels, great pieces of literature, or using the very same light, you can commit a murder also. So it is not the fault of the light, but it is the fault of the user. Similarly, we have been given, we always say, mind is in Bhagavad Gita, a person not less than Arjuna, he says to Sri Krishna that manam hi chanchalam hi manak Krishna. This mind is chanchala, this is restless. And to tayo nigraha means to control it is like vayo rivasu dushkaram. It is so difficult, just like to control wind. He asks this. And pramati balavadridam, chanchalam hi mana krishna pramati balav, tasya aham nigraham manye vayo rivasu dushkaram. Pramati balavadridam, and it is so forceful and it makes me commit mistakes, pramati. And that is the question Arjuna asks. Arjuna was not an ordinary person. But all the time we think that mind is the cause of all the problems. Because of my mind, I want to become good. But mera man mujhe achha nahi hone deta. This is my mind which is the villain of the piece. But that is not true, because the reply which he gives, Shri Krishna gives to that question, asamshayam hi mahabaho mano durnigraham chalam. Yes, it is undoubtedly mind is durnigraham, difficult to control, and it is restless, chalam. Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena chakrikyate. But through abhyasa, through practice, and through dispassion, you can control this mind. Now, who will do practice and who will practice dispassion? Who will do this abhyasa? Mind will do the abhyasa. Who will be dispassionate? Mind will be dispassionate. So see, while Arjuna says that mind is a problem, and Shri Krishna acknowledges that mind is definitely a problem, there is no doubt about it. But he says, use this very mind to attain the highest. And Sri Ramakrishna tells that when a person uses a ladder, he goes up on the rooftop, and then he says that there also this is same, everything, the ladder also through which he came, everything is same, made of everything. And then afterwards, he does not need the ladder. He gives another example that a person gets a letter and then he reads the contents of the letter, that such and such thing has to be purchased and sent. Once the contents of the letter he has understood, then he doesn't need the letter. Similarly, mind, what happens when a person attains the highest experience? At that moment, mind does not exist. We talk about nirvikalpa samadhi. In nirvikalpa samadhi, mind is not there. And mind gets dissolved. So the usage of mind or the utility of mind is not there. So we use mind only till we need it. Afterwards, we throw it away. So, but we can do everything using mind. Then Shankaracharya says, Dehadi sarva vishaye parikalpya ragam badnati tena purusham pashuvat gunena vairasya matra vishavat suvidhaya paschat enam vimochayati tanmana eva bandhat. He now explains how the mind operates, the modus operandi of mind, the way it operates. How does it operate? Dehadi sarva vishaye parikalpya ragam. It creates ragam. Ragam means not the singing raga. Here raga means attachment. It creates attachment.
Yeah.
Huh. It creates an attachment. No, it is not exactly like Bengali anurag, but raga means attachment. Anuraga raro anit manihati. Deha adi sarva vishaye. And it creates attachment in what? In sense objects. We have five senses and every sense has got some kind of object. So it creates attachment on these objects, starting with deha, body. That is our first attachment and the biggest attachment. In the Patanjali Yoga Sutras, it is called as abhinivesha, the clinging on to the body. So if a person sees a cockroach in bathroom, what happens?
Nothing.
Lot of confusion happens. It may not happen with you, but if a cockroach comes, so much confusion. So what will happen if they see a leopard? Yesterday, this person was going to the room and you see, at that moment I told him that leopards are found here. Timing. And some people lose sleep thinking that leopards will come. And that's why they are not able to get up. So it is like that. Life is like that, you see. So people are all afraid of leopards. So this is abhinivesha. Why is a person afraid of leopard? Because that fellow will make a breakfast out of me or lunch, depending on the size. So this leopard. Abhinivesha, clinging onto the body. Clinging onto the body. And not only body, but other things. First it is the body. Then just after body, it is the mobile phone. Or maybe. And once you have that attachment, then badnati tena purusham pashuvat gunena. And it binds you, badnati, it binds you. Purusham means a person, and like Pashuvat, guna here means robe. In Sanskrit, that is a beauty. You can have 1,000 meanings for the same. So you can actually scold somebody and then you can say, no, I was appreciating you. Go and see the dictionary. The same word means like that. So guna means quality. It also means robe, you see. So Pashuvat gunena, just like a animal is tied with ropes. A pashu means a beast is tied with ropes. So if you have a very ferocious dog, you tie it with ropes so that the dog doesn't go out of control. But here, tied with ropes, that it goes out of control. You are tied with something which is not your true nature. You are tied to something which is not your nature. You are tied to do that. So what could be an example? A person, an honest person, is working in a, say, government organization. Because India, that is presently the most dishonest place. So you are working in a government organization. The person is honest, doesn't want to take any bribe, wants to do everything on time and properly. But the persons who are senior to that person or junior to that person are not like that. And so what happens? This person got fixed or gets tied or bound in a situation which is totally against one's nature. See, it's not that person's nature to be corrupt or to be dishonest. So that is what happens. Badnati tena purusham pashuvat gunane. Just like a beast which is free to move, is bound by the ropes, not allowed to move freely. Similarly, the mind is bound by the mind. Mind gets creates attachment and it gets bound. It never heard of iPhone 6. But afterwards, one advertisement and you need that phone. It never heard of a person. In one Facebook profile it saw and chat and how are you, how am I and all that. And afterwards, tum nahi to hum nahi, hum nahi tum. So this is what? Parikalpyate. Mane, this creates an attachment, which is a bondage. And vairasya matra vishavat. And also, you see, that is the beauty of mind, that the same mind which creates attachment. What happens? Suddenly once a person sees, what is this world? This whole world is of no use to me. It has got no meaning to me. And this person maybe for so many lifetimes and so many births might have enjoyed so many things, so many kingdoms and so many things. Suddenly says, I don't want all these things. I just give up these because I don't like vaira. Vaira means, here it means, vaira means actually enmity. Here it means distaste or dispassion. Vishavat, he sees all these things to be poison. I don't want. In Bhagavad Gita, there is a shloka which says, where yogis are awake, other people sleep. And where other people sleep, yogis are awake. Means, when sense objects are there, the yogis, they are awake there, they are alert. And when enjoyment of sense objects are there, there they are asleep. Means they are indifferent to the enjoyment of sense objects. What happens? A person who can be bound by the mind because of attachment created on sense objects, the same mind can bring this consciousness that no, I don't want anything to do with sense objects. Suvidaya paschat, vishavat suvidaya, giving up. And that person, it comes. And then, paschad enam vimochayati tanmana eva bandhat. Bandhat tanmana eva vimochayati. Tatmana, that same mind, vimochayati, frees oneself from bandhat, from bondage. And the person, how? The person knows very clearly, suvidhaya, that these things are like poison for me. Vishavat, they are like poison for me. The person knows. What is the example? In Vishnu Purana, we find the story of a king, King Ayati. This king lived for 1,000 years and afterwards enjoyed so many things and then said that I want to enjoy still. So he asked the life of his son and the son also gave his life. Some system was there those days. You can just like that give that life. So, have you seen that there was a movie, Time? Have you seen?
No.
Nobody has seen. In that movie, you can just, instead of money, it is all time. So, there will be a watch or something and you can just give like that. You go to a coffee shop and instead of money, there will be time. So, a poor person means that person has no time to live. So like some hours are only there. So the person is dying, somebody is dying and the hero goes and gives time and saves that person. Some science fiction movie. So like that, this person got 1,000 years from his son. Then he was not satisfied. He asked for another 1,000 years from another son. And even then he was not satisfied. And then he himself realized that what am I doing? I am constantly enjoying sense objects, but am I getting any satisfaction? He says, no, not by trying to appease the desires or trying to fulfill the desires, satisfy the desires, you cannot attain peace of mind or you cannot attain fulfillment. It is not possible. Just like in fire, if you put ghee, fire will not be put down. Fire will not extinguish. It will only become stronger and stronger. So that idea, who got? That idea Yayati got. Who was doing the sense enjoyment? Yayati was doing the sense enjoyment. And both times, all the time, it was the same mind of this king which was making him enjoy those sense experiences. And at a sudden moment, suddenly, he got this flash of wisdom. So this is the wonderful nature of mind. Now it is up to us how to train the mind so that we don't get bound, but we go on the path of freedom. So that mind does not pulls us down, but helps us to go up and up. How do we do that? That is our task. That is our capacity or our capability. And that is why it is told that whatever you will tell the mind, it will do. Tasmat manaha karanamasya jantoho bandasya mokshasya chavavidhane bandasya hetu malinam rajogunaihi mokshasya shuddham virajas tamaskam. So, tasmat, therefore, Shankaracharya says in this verse, manaha jantao bandhasya mokshasya karanam. Mind is the cause, just like I was quoting that Amrita Binda Upanishad. Mind is the cause for the bandha or bondage and also moksha, liberation of jantu, of a living being, of a person. And bandhasya hetu malinam. How do you get bondage? It is by malinam, by some kind of dross or some kind of rubbish, some kind of taint, some kind of stain which comes into your mind. Because of that, you get bondage, you get bounded, you get bound. And how does that come? That is the effect of rajogunaihi. Rajoguna. It is the effect of rajoguna. So, rajoguna, if you try to strengthen rajaguna or rajoguna, rajas gun of your mind, then there will be a lot of stain. And then your mind will be put into bondage. Mokshasya shuddham. Virajaha tamaskam. Virajaha tamaskam. When the mind is pure of rajoguna and tamoguna. When the mind is pure of rajoguna and tamoguna, then one gets a mind which will help you, which is conducive to moksha, liberation. So what is the first step of spiritual life? Is to try to increase the sattva element in your mind, to increase the predominance of sattva guna in your mind. And slowly give up or reduce the strength of rajoguna or tamoguna. That is the, so first thing which people ask is, get up early in the morning. Because that is tamoguna, you are giving up tamoguna. Then they ask that you try to control your mind, control inner sense organs, external sense organs. So this is asking you to give up slowly rajoguna. What is the main characteristic of rajoguna? It is desire. Fulfillment of desire. Rajoguna is, I did this. I purchased this car. I built this house. They are my kids. Actually, some parents, they are so happy. First, I could, even now I don't understand that. They will say, you see Maharaj, how nicely I have brought them up. Not that. That is okay. Bringing up is a very difficult thing. They will say that this is my kid. So that itself is my great contribution to humanity. That I have given birth to kids. So I don't say, but even dogs and pigs give birth to kids. So what is the great contribution? So that is what people think, that I have done this great thing. I have done that. I have done this. This is a predominant quality of rajoguna. And I will do that. All the desire for activity, for one's own pride or to fulfill one's own desire is Rajoguna. There could be a different kind of activity, which is a selfless activity. That is Sattva Guna. That is born out of Sattva Guna. So the idea of spiritual life is to slowly give up these two gunas, Rajoguna and Tamoguna, and develop more and more of Sattva Guna. And what is the characteristic of Sattva Guna? It is that you will feel inner calm and peace at all times. Every time, whatever problem may come, the world may go topsy-turvy, but you will feel inner poise and calm. That is the characteristic of Sattva Guna. While commenting on the Patanjali Yoga Sutra, Swamiji very nicely says that the first sign that you are becoming sattvic is that you will become cheerful. The first sign that you are becoming religious is that you will become cheerful. Most of the people, they have problems. So, but this you will not have, and you will be cheerful, and always you will have a pleasant disposition. Your face will be always nice. Almost all of the people, if you see the face, then you feel like committing suicide. But that will not happen. You will be smiling, and when you see somebody, other person also will feel like, yes, good, etc. So that is the sign of Sattva. And that Sattva Guna will constantly increase if you do practices of controlling your mind and also external sense organs. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.
कौन सा श्लोक है ये
174 नहीं नहीं बीच में बंद हो गया ना